Why female hyenas have male organs, biology of hyenas. The hyena has been subjected to more embarrassing lies than the sloth in the animal kingdom. They've been branded as nature's thugs throughout history, across nations and continents, as dim-witted cowards that lurk in dark alleyways waiting for an opportunity to rob other, more noble, creatures of their supper. The spotted hyena, Crocuta, is the largest, most widespread, and most misunderstood of the four hyena species. This so-called laughing hyena may not be the prettiest of creatures, with its scruffy fur, bent back, and huge, drooling grin. But our contempt isn't just superficial, it's personal. So let's get started. Number 6. The hyena's bewildering biology is partly to blame. Although it has the appearance and hunting abilities of a dog, this animal actually belongs to the mongoose family and is therefore more closely related to a cat than it is to a dog. After publishing numerous versions of his book Systema Naturae, the Swedish biologist Carl Linnaeus classified the hyena as a cat, then as a dog, until finally classifying it as both. He was never able to get it right. Perhaps even more perplexing than the dilemma of what kind of animal the hyena is, was the fundamental matter of its gender. It is a common misconception that the hyena possesses both sexes in itself, acting as a male for part of 1 year and a female for the rest of the year, stated Pliny the Elder in his Animal Encyclopedia. This was not the first or the last time that someone suggested that the hyena was a hermaphrodite, according to the Roman biologist. The rumor was widespread in African folklore, and Aristotle questioned whether it was true or not. The hyena, on the other hand, is not one of the more than 65,000 documented cross-sexual species that have been recognized by modern research. Number 5. Hyena's wildly unconventional genitalia, which are a near-perfect facsimile of the males. Despite the fact that the Crocuta's clitoris is only about 8 inches in length, it is shaped and positioned exactly like a penis, earning it the nickname pseudopenis among those in the scientific community. They are even capable of inducing erections in themselves. She appears to have her own set of testicles, thanks to the fact that her labia have fused together to form a false scrotum, which is stuffed with fatty tissue swellings that are mistaken for male gonads, which is quite comprehensible. Researchers such as Paul A. Racy and Jennifer D. Skinner have published articles on the spotted hyena's sexual mimicry, and they have asserted that the appearances of the male and female are so similar that the sex can only be determined with certainty by probing the scrotum. Number 4. Hyena is the only known mammal with no external vaginal opening. Instead, she uses her multitasking pseudopenis to urinate, copulate, and give birth. This last effort is akin to squeezing a cantaloupe from a hosepipe, and 10% of first-time hyena mothers perish in the process. Their cub's fate is more precarious, as the umbilical cord is too small to cross a delivery canal that is double the length of a similar-sized mammal's and features a devious hairpin curve halfway down. On their way out, up to 60% of cubs suffocate. The sight of a male hyena giving birth through his penis gave rise to the hermaphrodite legend, as well as a few lingering nightmares. The female's gender bending extends beyond her phallus. Female spotted hyenas are substantially larger and more aggressive than males, making them unique among mammals. You don't want to be a male spotted hyena, Kay Hollekamp, a Michigan State University evolutionary biology and behavior professor, told me. She spent more than 3 decades studying Crocuta in the wild, creating a new portrait of these misunderstood animals and earning the moniker Jane Goodall of hyenas. Number 3. Every hyena clan is a matriarchy ruled by an alpha female. The alpha female's line transfers supremacy down to her cubs in the clan's tight power system. Adult itinerant guys are at the bottom of the food chain, reduced to subservient outcasts yearning for approval, food, and sex. These mature males eat last if there's anything left at a communal carcass, where 30 or more hyenas may be fighting for their pound of flesh or risk violent vengeance from the sisterhood. The severe rivalry over carcasses, according to Hollekamp, is the driving force behind the female-spotted hyena's hostility and dominance. In less than 30 minutes, a swarm of hyenas can convert a 550-pound adult zebra into a crimson stain on the grass. An adult may consume up to one-third of its body weight in a single meal, or between 33 and 44 pounds of beef. It's a hectic, chaotic, and occasionally terrifying scene. A larger, meaner female has a greater chance of ensuring that her surviving cubs have a seat at the table while avoiding injury. Dominant females have another technique in their sleeves to give their pups an aggressive edge. According to a new study by Hollekamp, the more powerful a woman is, the more testosterone her fetuses are exposed to during the third trimester of pregnancy. The ovaries of the mother create these androgens, which is unique enough. Female cubs, according to Hollekamp, are more vulnerable to their effects than male cubs. Because spotted hyenas have a long gestation period, marinating in this prenatal androgen bath influences the development of the cub's neural system, making them primed to fight from the time they're born. And they already have the weapons they need. Hyena cubs, unlike most mammals, emerge with their eyes open, muscles coordinated, and teeth pierced through their gums and ready to bite. Number 2. Humans and hyenas are long-standing enemies. Marcus Bainsrock, an Australian anthropologist who spent several years in Ethiopia studying the interaction between our two species, has some theories as to why. He explained to me that both humans and hyenas are highly clever social predators with origins in the African savanna. But the hyenas had arrived first, so as our distant ancestors descended from the trees, they were squeezing into the spotted hyena's territory. The hyena's bone-crunching bite, according to Bainsrock, could possibly be the explanation for the lack of evidence of early human evolution. Most hominid fossils are merely teeth and jawbones, he explained. When you locate teeth, it's nearly a certainty that the deceased individual passed through a hyena's digestive tract, because that's all that comes out. Our forefathers had only the most basic stone tools and were most likely scavenging rather than hunting. They wouldn't have been able to defend their prize meal from a pack of hungry hyenas, according to bones from the time period that show cut marks from early stone tools mixed with hyena tooth marks, implying that hyenas have been laughing at us and stealing our dinner for as long as 2.5 million years. It's no surprise that we dislike them. Number 1. Teamwork of hyenas. In the end, the hyenas' amazing success in bringing down enormous prey, terrifying lions, and raising their cubs in a difficult environment is dependent on their ability to work together as a group of animals. According to recent fieldwork, the spotted hyena's social structures are every bit as complex as those of baboons, and CT scans have confirmed that hyena brains have evolved in a similar frontal direction to that of primates, with the region involved in complex decision-making being significantly enlarged. When it comes to cooperative problem-solving exercises, they have even outperformed chimpanzees in several instances. That living in a complex fission-fusion society is due to chimps and hyenas, as well as dolphins, other primates, and of course humans, is essential for the evolution of large brains is supported by this finding. This may even provide an explanation for why our species has evolved a brain that is 7 times larger than what would be expected for an animal our size, according to current theories. In addition, this shared section of the evolutionary path may hold the key to understanding our unwavering loathing for these cunning creatures. What do you think about our video? Please let us know in the comments area below. If you enjoyed this video and would want to hear from me again, please subscribe and turn on the notification before leaving. Thank you for watching us.